Hi everyone, I'm Caitlin James from Scalp Micropigmentation Australia and welcome to another 5 minute fast facts on Scalp Micropigmentation, the Pro Artist Series, where we're interviewing some amazing scalp micropigmentation artists from around the world, getting their tips and tricks on how you can get the best out of your scalp micropigmentation transformation. Today we are lucky enough to have two scalp micropigmentation artists joining us and we are spread over three very different time zones, so this has been an amazing effort to get us all together. Today we are joined by Jeff Picasso from LA, the owner of Leaders Academy, and he has really made a statement in the SMP industry by creating some really clear, sophisticated and unique branding for his scalp micropigmentation empire. He's also based in Chicago as well as LA in the USA. He has a strong barbering background and Jeff is also a MicroBew 2019 Elite Artist and was a finalist for the Team Micro Best Training Program and is also a part of the Elite FYT Pro Team. We also have the beautiful Ari from Ireland. She has excelled in teaching and has teaching scalp micropigmentation and has two articles published in magazines for her ladies using scalp micropigmentation. She also placed top two for best international artist at the Team Micro Awards last year. Welcome, Ari. How are you?
Yeah, all good, thanks.
Excellent. Thank you so much, both of you, for joining us.
It's a pleasure. Thank you for having us on here.
No worries. So today we're going to be chatting about your hybrid training for scalp micropigmentation today. But first, just so our listeners and viewers can get to know you a little bit better, Jeff, tell us a little bit about your background. How did you come to start sort of your scalp micropigmentation career? And why did you decide to have scalp micropigmentation yourself?
Yeah, I started scalp micropigmentation about 6 years ago. I did it because as a barber and as just a young man, I was always thinning hair. When I was 23, 24, I started thinning hair. I would always wear hats and I always would be ashamed of my hair loss. I looked older than I was and it got my confidence real bad. I was scared, not scared, but I couldn't go to events like my sister's wedding. I couldn't do stuff where I participated in because I had to wear a hat. In some places, you can't wear a hat. Mm-hmm. So it was something that when I got it done, it really impacted me to a point where I feel like it's my own hair and it doesn't even feel like I have a tattoo on my head. So I wish I would have done this earlier. Mm-hmm. And I'm happy that I got it done. And anybody that wants to get this done, I would say don't hesitate and don't wait and get it done ASAP. But if I didn't get the SMP, I probably would always be wearing a hat like I am right now. And I would probably be, I don't know. I don't know where I would be. I would probably be with cutting hair. I wouldn't be where I'm at right now. Everything happens for a reason. When I learned SMP, I think me and you went to the same location. I was trained hands-on, but in Arizona by the same company. Yeah. But just starting off there and getting the basics and not knowing really what to do, it was kind of challenging. And an online training is a little bit more challenging if you don't even know what depth or how to hold the pen and stuff like that. So in a way, it's not as easy as it looks.
Yeah.
It's not as easy as it looks. You have to really, really study and really, really practice. There's no way you could learn just by watching a video or just by practicing on a melon. It's much more because you have to know the depth, you have to know the skin type, you have to know ethnicity, age, age-appropriate hairlines, and so much more. But having a foundation in barbering helped me tremendously into getting into scalp micropigmentation because hairlines is half of the thing you have to know. You know, the other is the depth and the right formula and all that good stuff you know about.
Yeah, brilliant. Excellent. And Ari, tell us, why did you decide to add scalp micropigmentation into your already successful permanent makeup business?
I think for two reasons. What happened is at the very beginning when I was starting with permanent makeup, I knew exactly that I want to do scalp micropigmentation. Why two reasons? Like, I did suffer on the hair loss after pregnancy. So many women are affected, kind of hair loss or hair thinning. So there was one point where I went across scalp micropigmentation and I knew that there was something, you know, what could cure my problem. And then another thing, I was having around myself so many people with the bald heads, like loads of guys, loads of friends. So I knew there is another thing, how I can help them, you know. And especially there was a kind of a time when everyone lost to be bald, lost to go to the gym, you know, there's like loads of things involving into it and they didn't have their hair. So I knew, well, that's the thing, how I can help them. And I can change their appearance and, you know, change the way how they think about themselves. But that's exactly as Jeff said. I had so many friends who were wearing heads, but when I told them there's an option that they can take them off and they can enjoy their lives, they were like, wow, what's it? Like, what kind of, I don't know, magic treatment do you have? So that's those two reasons why I really badly wanted to start it. I do SMP a little bit shorter than Jeff, but I'm just falling in love. So that's the thing why I'm just traveling across the world, you know, just to get more knowledge about it.
Yeah, brilliant. All right, and Jeff, let's talk about the Atrading Academy. Tell us, where did the idea to start training artists come from? Why did you want to create the academy?
So the academy or the online portion?
Or both of it. You can have a chat about both of it. Yeah.
Well, so the academy came about because I ran into an artist called Masood. He's out of Montreal, Canada. And we both had the same passion for SMP, and I seen how his style is and how my style is, and we put our styles together, and then from there it just happened. It's like spontaneous on the training, the idea, and then from there we just put our values into one big program where we could offer our tips and tricks and how to become a better artist and not to go through all those pitfalls like I did and he did when we first started. But it just came from us just thinking about it and creating it and putting it out there. The online training we created a year ago. It's not something that we created a couple months ago. We created this a year ago to piggyback our training, our hands-on training. Because what we noticed is a lot of people we train, when we get to the first, second, and third day, they're unaware of how to hold a pen or any other drawing hairlines. So if we give them something to prepare themselves, like an online course, then by the time we see them on the first, second, third, fourth day, they'll be a little bit versed in how to do SMP. So that's why we created it. And it's beneficial for hands-on, and we recommend if you're doing the online training that you piggyback that with a hands-on course at any of our trainings or in Los Angeles or Canada or in Ireland. So we're not substituting online training for hands-on SMP training, because it's just much more than that. Just like how you got trained, you know, you needed more hands-on, right? You just can't learn off watching videos.
Yeah, absolutely. So when, because you did start training around the same time as myself, and there wasn't a lot of options available to us at that time. So how did you find your original training? How did you go in your first couple of clients? Did you find it fairly difficult?
Yeah. So when, I got the training like you did, and it was super, super basic. It was just doing dots on the melon, and everything else didn't make sense. What needle to use, using a 1RL and shifting and switching to a 3RL like we use now.
Yeah.
Hairlines, it was just one hairline for everybody, and like a barber hairline. You know what I'm talking about. It doesn't matter if you're 40 or 21. Everybody was getting that, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Thick skin, scars, all of that I didn't learn. It was just all my first year trial and error, and and just seeing what happens. And from there, learning from mistakes. That's how I learned from just from mistakes. Mm-hmm. I really didn't talk to other artists and share like pointers like we do now. That first year I started, it was kind of taboo. It was kind of more separate than it is now. To me.
Absolutely. Yeah, definitely. I feel like it was probably anywhere between 1 to 2 years after I began as well that people actually started opening up a little bit more and sharing some more ideas online. And is that sort of the basics then of you wanting to create an online academy and or the hands-on training, like to create something a little bit more thorough?
You know what? When I left the previous company where me and you were working, that was one of the reasons why, because I seen how the trainings were going. And there was a lot of people dropping out. There was a lot of people that didn't even take it to the next level because you weren't even taught what the right way to do it. So I wanted, and Masood wanted something that's a lot better than what we had. And we're always answering DMs. We're always inboxing. There's always a question. It's not like we block people and stuff like that, like some people have done.
Mm. Yeah.
Go ahead.
Tell us, because, I mean, you've got Ari in Ireland, you've got Masood in Montreal. Where do all your students come from? Because you're all quite well spread out all over the place. So this really has opened up, the doors for many people all over the world to learn this. Where have you found some of your students have come from?
You want to answer that, Ari?
Yeah, literally, like as you said there, it comes from everywhere. Like we've got requests from Brazil, where we used to be on the conference, people across the Europe, Poland, of course, Ireland, UK, France, Istanbul, east side of Europe as well. What I was saying, yeah, there's loads of people like coming from everywhere because, you know, through social media, everyone can find out about leaders, so people are sharing posts and they are talking about it. So I wouldn't be surprised that, you know, we're gonna, I don't know, get people from everywhere because we are getting them.
Yeah,
it's only the fact that the moment we cannot try them, you know, because of the virus. But when everything will settle down, I'm sure like we're gonna have like a good plan of trainings worldwide.
Brilliant.
Am I right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And Caitlin, let me ask you a question. Where do you get most of your clients from? Do a lot of people travel from USA to go to Australia?
No, we as in clients that I treat?
No. Do SMP.
Yeah, no, generally all within Australia. We don't generally find that we have many from international at all. It all tends to be all within Australia here.
Yeah, because I have a lot of clients that want to go to Australia to get it done by you guys.
Oh, really? That's brilliant.
Yeah. they tell me.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Tell us in detail then about your two-step program. How much time do you generally set aside for the online, and how much time do you like to see your students face-to-face for the hands-on training?
You're talking about right now in this coronavirus or after?
What would the general be? So say if traveling wasn't an issue at the moment, what would you generally put aside for online training? How long do you expect them to take to go through your online component before they then come and do however many days hands-on?
Yeah. So they have to pass the whole course before they go on a hands-on training. And we know who is slacking off and who's not, because we have a report. So by the time we see you on the first day, we know who's been studying and who hasn't. So at the end of the day, we know who really wants it and who doesn't, you know. So we check on them. And also on the online training, we have mandatory check a Zoom with us like we're right now, so we can see if they're up to par, so that keeps us entailed on how they are progressing in SMP.
Yeah, brilliant. And how many days do you set aside for your hands-on training at one of your training programs?
Depend the location, between 3 days and some 4 days.
Yeah.
The online training is about 30 hours.
Yeah. Brilliant. And that's self-paced, so they can sort of take their time doing that online training?
Of course. You could do it from the privacy of your own home. You don't have to be dressed up. Sometimes I have students they feel a little bit overwhelmed and they're pressured. They feel like they can't do it. And it's a little slower pace for some students that this might be totally different from them. Maybe they were Uber drivers or secretaries and they jump into a new field. So it's something a little slow paced. And if you like it, then you'll attend a hands-on that we're doing to take it to the next step. So it's taking gradual steps.
Yeah. Brilliant. And if we have someone watching or listening to this show today, where can they find the information on the Leaders Academy?
Yes, www.leaderssmp.com. That's LEADERS and another S, MP.com. And my Instagram's Picasso Jeff. Yep. So you could reach me or reach the website and we'll get in contact.
Yeah, brilliant. And Ari, would you like to share with us one of your favorite client transformation stories, how scalp micropigmentation has really changed the life of one of your favorite clients?
Just now, Jeff reminded me a story about one fella that's again about the hat. I remember that so confident guy who came to my place, and I was wondering, are you sure that you need it? Like, you feel so good with your bald head. But he said, I do pretend that I'm happy with it, but I'm not. So that shows us how people are putting their mask and they smile fake, pretending they don't bother about the hair loss, but they do. So that's why I especially have SMP, because he wanted to take off his hat when he's going to church, and he wasn't able to do it, so he wasn't going to the church. So I would say the faith really pushed him to do it. And I remember how delighted he was. He came for the very last session with his wife, his kids, the flowers. So it meant a lot for him. It meant a lot.
Yeah, and also if you see, there's positive and also there's a repercussion. They're all bad is botched, or they got the procedure done by someone that doesn't know what they're doing, and you know they're more ashamed, they're more depressed. So it works way. So you have to make sure that when you SMP, you go to a well-trained artist in your area that knows what they're doing, because there's a lot of people that are doing this and really don't know what they're doing.
Yeah. And it is always good when you are trying to find the right artist for you to find out just how many trainings that artist has taken, because quite often a really well-rounded practitioner has done more than one training, which is really comforting to know, because there's many different styles, many different ways, many different techniques of creating beautiful SMP. So just because you've taken one training, you know, it should never stop there. And so going on and doing further training and taking more than one fundamental course is always a great idea.
Yeah, always learning. I'm still learning. I watch other artists and I always try to get as much knowledge as I can. So it's you never stop learning. You know, you never know it all in SMP. It's something it's an ongoing process. And the more you educate yourself, the more you do more trainings, the more that you ask, the better you'll become as an artist. Because if you stay quiet and stay to yourself and don't and think an online training or one training hands-on is going to make it, it's much more than that.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. I think we can all agree that multiple trainings is a really good idea.
Of course. Yeah. How many days are your trainings over there?
We do generally 4-day training course, but we do the online component prior to as well. So we usually give them 4 weeks to complete the online. Before then, they would do a hands-on 4 days intensive hands-on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I'll ask a question. Does the training, the online training, is it something that's been beneficial to prior than not using the online training and just doing hands-on straight?
We We do go back over it in detail at the hands-on training, but if they can get their knowledge up and read a lot of the background of the SMP before they come to do the training, we still go through it, but we tend to sort of touch on everything rather than have to sit there and explain it in detail. So the online component has been great for speeding up the process of the fundamental knowledge that they should know before they come in and what we expect them to know before they come in. And within the online training, we have little quizzes and things like that. So we know where they're at as well and if they're actually logging in and doing what they should be doing.
Of course.
That is something, you know, that we find some people are better than others at, and some people are very hands-on people and they don't like reading and they don't like the knowledge, which is why we still tend to go back over it at the online the hands-on training. So thank you so much for sharing your experience with us, both of you, today. We really appreciate the time that you set aside to have a chat, and thanks for being a part of the 5-minute fast facts on scalp micropigmentation, the Pro Artist series. I'm sure an artist out there or someone that's considering scalp micropigmentation has learned something from our little conversation today. So thank you both so much.
Thank you for having us. We appreciate it. Thank you. And we'll talk again.
Absolutely. And as always, if you've got any questions or comments, we want to hear from you. So don't be shy. Give us a call or an email. Pop something in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on the latest content as it's released. Thanks so much, guys. We hope to see you soon.
Thank you. Bye.